What is it?
Never mind.
A simple matter.
Let's go.
Fine.
Wait, I went in here. What about here? Not seeing a temple yet.
Name it. No problem at all.
Got it.
What? Fine. Such menial tasks.
I usually don't care when we go in bookshelves. History of the Dales and the Elven Court. History of the Chosen of Mistra. Can't pick it up. But
good to go. No problem at all.
I wonder if we could sell it, actually. It's an extra copy.
Yes, a simple matter.
Something else? No problem at all.
I'm in the way. When the back is turned, it's okay. Yeah, we're not getting in there. Oops. Oh my.
No problem at all.
Books. History of the North 3. I think we're missing that one. And 4 extra copy we could probably sell. It's not overweight yet, so let's keep grabbing it.
What is it? Such menial tasks.
Life's been getting prickly on me, ours.
Burglars, explain thyself, lest the guards loose you from your life. I mean no harm. I shall leave at once. As well you should. Be gone from mine home. Okay. I'll be gone from your home.
Fine.
Something on your mind?
Nope.
Speak up, speak up!
Oh, jeez. Is the road out of here? Lucal?
I've no time for to talk to you now.
I've lost 10 head of cattle in the last month alone. Gall darn raiders must be getting into rustling, I figure. Bandits are stealing local cattle, according to one of the farmers. Who is this? Oh, this Gollin Vend who was gonna... Well, he did actually tell us about this area. Seemed like he was actually gonna show us around, but instead he just gave out info. Another farmer.
I've no time for to talk to you now.
Now, I've been here before, actually. Just to refresh you guys' memory, if you guys didn't watch the part zero of it, I have played up to, but not including the town of Nashkal. So I've been to these areas. I think that the temple might be in a separate area. Maybe.
You need something, stranger?
Speak up, speak up!
Aye, the world has fallen apart around us, and here before me lie a band of groveling adventurers, preying on my every word to hear rumors of the latest dungeon fad. Dungeons? You're pathetic. Okay, I'll rattle it off for you like I did for the last adventurer, and the one before that. I have no doubt you'll share their fate. Let's see, there are the ruins of an old mage school to the southeast. Traps, dead things that try to kill you, you know the shtick. Then there's the fire wine bridge, ghosts, winding narrow passageways, some poetry, blah blah blah. Honestly, I can't think of a life more tedious than that of an adventurer. Personally, I get far more out of wandering around aimlessly and scratching my arse like this. Okay. Whatever. Yeah, apparently we've been everywhere then. So wait. Bear ghost. I'm not seeing it. There's an Ashkel mine. And there's a town I've been to. Look at these areas. Look at a speared. Nice, look at all this. Not completely sure we can get to all these areas. I mean, maybe. Guessing not. Maybe. I don't know. Well, there's, Calumport. The Shining Sea. The Lake of Steam. There's a Sea of Fallen Stars. I just read about that recently. Westgate. High Moon. Baldur's Gate itself, right here. Somewhere far north. Oh, Icewind Dale. The Sword Coast. The Sea of Swords. They Marsh. So I wonder where is Waterdeep? Well, that sounds cool. Gorge of the Fallen Idol. Daggerford. Just naming out some places that sound familiar to me. Alright. Where are we? There we are. Well, we need to resurrect her. We have enough money to do it. I think it's 100 to resurrect? I'm not sure. Handout? Jeez.
Fine.
Hey!
Must dash to Baragost, I must. Governor Keldath must be told of the extra troops being sent this way. Baragost is to be garrisoned in case of Omnian attack, though Om has denied such intent. Of course they would deny it. The snakes. Make way for the messenger.
Alright. You funny looking!
Don't you be getting any closer. I'll have Mom come and give you the belt. Relax, kid. I don't want to hurt you. Oh, sure. That's what the other group of bandits said. And then they went and attacked the caravan I just saw leave. They were a bunch of liars. Probably just like you. Get lost. Is this your father? I mean, I hope you're here with somebody. Baragost to the south. Okay, where the hell is this temple?
Fine.
I guess I didn't come across it. I think if you head in one direction or another, you come across it. It's like the next zone. We just want to raise her before we do anything. Well, that last guy who tried to kill me was rather tough. Oh, it's raining now. Temple! Good.
Such menial tasks.
Let's just head right to the temple. Anything we find, we'll have a hard time carrying. Song of the Morning Temple. Oh. It's all one area. Rochelle?
Salutations.
Greetings to you from a humble servant of Lothander, Rachel the Sunray. What kind of aid can I give you? Do you sell magical healing or scrolls? The most radiant of Lothander, Keldath Ormlyr, should be able to help you with this, my good woman. It can be found in the Song of the Morning Temple. I thought that's where I was. Is there anything else you wish to know? Please tell me about this temple. Her face lights up with pride. The Song of the Morning is the name of our temple, consecrated in the name of the Morning Land Lothander. Morning Lord, sorry. We protect the good people of Baragost. The servants of the Morning Lord also tend temple fields of potatoes and herb flowers east of the road, and keep sheep on the slopes of the hill topped by the ruined sword, the ruined school of Ulcaster. Can't speak. The sheep are more easily watched there, preventing theft and raiding beasts from ravaging them. It allows us some control over expeditions into the ruins and to prevent expansion of Baragost. Oh, you don't want it to expand. Over the years, various Omnian merchants have shown a distressing tendency to lay claim to all land within easy reach of the coastway that's not strongly defended. I had an option to say something about, ask about the surrounding area, and that's gone. Walk in the blessed light of the sun, my good woman.
How are you?
Yes, can you tell us about the lands nearby? You are now in Baragost, my good woman. It was a village once, under the protection of the School of Wizardry, the Olcaster School it was called, for it was founded by Olcaster, a conjurer of some renown, but it was ruined by Kalashate mages out of fear. But the most radiant of Lothander, Kaldath Ormlir, frowns upon us, talking of this haunted place, let alone approaching it. Cromer Darn family of Am has estates nearby, and they breed fine horses, highly prized in Am and Tethir. To northwest stands High Hedge, the estate of Thalantir the Conjurer. He is a loner, I think, and doesn't welcome visitors. Yeah, we've met. However, he's said to be interested in far-off places and things, so if you have anything peculiar for sale, you might try your luck. Alright, we can go in here then. Cyrene, and Cyrene, and Kaldath Ormlir.
Such menial tasks.
I guess they've taken a vow of silence. Here's another one. Hail, Kaldath.
Welcome! The traveling adventurer is never turned away from a house of Lothander.
As we strive to aid all who make a difference in the realms, if you are battle-worn, we can extend a number of necromantic restorations. Whatever you need, a small donation is all the compensation that we require. What kind of aid can you give us? Buy and sell. Identify. Healing. I could buy a scroll of Raise Dead, but I can't use it, right?
Don't touch me. I'm super important.
Can we donate for a resurrection? While your donation to the temple was considerable, it was not enough to gain a reputation point. The Midsummer Fair is being held down in Nashkel. I don't know how well it'll do with all the troubles that have been about these regions of place. People can't risk traveling for a simple little carnival. Do we want this? When this spell is cast, the life energy level of the recipient is raised. Oh, this is not for a dead person, right? This reverses any previous life energy level drained the creature by a force or a monster. A greater restoration spell will also restore the intelligence score of a creature affected by the feeble mind spell and negate any form of insanity, such as confusion or berserk. It fully heals the target and cures any diseases or poisons. Casting the spell is very draining on the priest and will likely require rest immediately afterwards. You know why? I think we have to have her selected. Okay, resurrection or raised dead. When the priest casts a raised dead spell, she can restore life to a dwarf, gnome, half-elf, halfling, elf, half-orc, or human. Note that the body of the person must be whole, otherwise missing parts are still missing when the person is brought back to life. The person has but one hit point when raised and must regain the rest by natural healing or curative magic. Resurrection. Like the 5th level spell, Raised Dead, Resurrection will turn a character back to life. However, Resurrection also heals the character so that they are ready for the adventuring life right away. Well, she only has 4 hit points. So I think we can do with Raise Dead. Can I still look at her character sheet? Because I think she loses a point of constitution, doesn't she? Constitution 14.
Yes?
Don't
Fine.
Touch me. I'm super important.
I'm sure you are.
What is it this time?
Glad to be back from the dead, I see. Constitution's still 14, okay. Now you can have your stuff back. And a 50 pound, let's see. Carry some books too. Make yourself useful. Taking his belt back off. If you come across something that uses a lot of ice magic, maybe I'll remember to put it on. Alright, I guess we can look around now. Is there anything else that I forgot to give her? We still have to look around that inn, the one that we were attacked in. We were forced to flee. We could barely carry anything, and one of our members was dead. Alright, let's look around here while we're here.
I'll do it!
What is a simple matter?
These will all go just outside? That's kind of creepy.
Fine.
Just explore, clear the fog away. If I remember right, there's a whole bunch of nothing here. What are these? Wargs? We are not in the shape to be fighting these things. They're not pursuing. I didn't know think there would be anything out here as far as wildlife. Let's head back to town. Are you kidding me? A hobgoblin? Missing. We are not in the shape to deal with these things. How do we get in? There should be a door right here. Is he still chasing us? I'm not sure. And the battle music stopped. So there's another building here. I didn't even realize that. Let's head back to town. I didn't think there was anything out here you could fight. Well, that would want to fight you. Would that even be existing? Good. I was afraid it wouldn't let us go back.
A simple matter.
Whew. We need to rest some more. Let's go back to the inn. I should rest a few times. All they have is merchant there. I mean, we could travel, you know, go to another inn, go to Fellpost's. But I do want to explore this inn as well, so might as well. Hopefully if we just sleep two or three nights or rounds of 8 hours, we'll be back to full or close to it.
You want some whiskey?
Merchant is 3.
All this traveling, all this adventure, how do you manage it? Until now, I was barely able to keep my head above water. Yet here with you, it seems almost easy.
I think you're forgetting the fact that you actually died. Easy? We face our share of danger, Neera.
Oh, well, yes, there's obviously that. I just meant that ordinary things are easier. I'm not constantly worried where my next meal is coming from, or whether a kobold will sneak up and slit my throat as I sleep.
No, he'll just walk up to all of us and attack us. And that was your life before we met?
Yes. Rocks for a pillow, eating clay, all that and more. My fortune seems to have come in waves. It has ever since High Forest.
You ate clay? High Forest, is that where you came from?
That's me. Born and raised in the thicket. At least until my mistakes piled up high enough to come crashing down on me.
What drove you out of your home?
You know, this and that. I was never a very good student of magic, and part of that could be attributed to never studying. I ended up flubbing a few spells, and here I am.
It would appear that you've glossed over some of the finer details.
A maiming or two, if you don't count the second-degree burns. Completely accidental, and everybody lived. Well, at least I'm pretty sure everybody lived.
Accidents happen, even horrible ones.
You really know how to get someone to open up. Why, yes, let me just share intimate details about my past. You put me right at ease.
Take your time. Tell me when you're ready.
During our magical training, we were supposed to summon a sphere of fire. And mine got away from me somehow. One moment I was concentrating, the next moment my classmates were rolling on the floor screaming.
Oh god. Remind me to stand back when you cast a spell. You don't need to rub it in. I know better than anyone the harm I've caused. You can't blame yourself.
Of course I can blame myself. Accident or not, I should have been more careful. I could have taken responsibility or at least fetched a bucket of water. Instead, I ran away, terrified of what I'd done.
You didn't even try to help? Horrible, I know. Afterwards, I ran into the woods and couldn't bear to go back to face the consequences. I snuck back into the village, now and then for food, but once to leave a note for my parents, but eventually I had to leave.
I took to wandering High Forest, but I kept running into the wrong people and doing the wrong thing. Eventually, Turlang the tree and grabbed me and said, "Take a hike." Well, maybe not in those words exactly.
A tree ain't great, well. So nasty. And so you left on your journey.
And so I left High Forest. I've been wandering for a while now. I've got a few ideas for a destination, but I'm still considering them. Come, let us continue this journey together.
Neera said she left High Forest after a spellcasting accident maimed several of her fellow students. It doesn't sound as though her teachers banished her, but she seems to think they would have kicked her out if she hadn't chosen to flee. Her judgment doesn't seem to be the best, but I think there's a good heart behind her frivolous attitude.